What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to the Tampa Bay Buccaneers franchise. It's time for week five as we're set to take on the 3-1 Kansas City Chiefs. This game should be a big one. Obviously, we're coming off a win over the Denver Broncos to end last episode, but the game we watched, we lost to the New York Giants 27-26. Neither ground game played well, neither defense was great against the pass game as David Cole and Teddy Bridgewater put up big numbers. Unfortunately, Cole's good effort late in the ball game did not get us the win as the runoff killed any chance we had, but this was a good game and we've got some good matchups going forward. Hopefully we don't find ourselves in a similar situation in the future. So we find ourselves in pretty good standing four games in, unfortunately not undefeated as we could have been one of the four teams remaining. Looks like another good year for Kyler Murray and the Arizona Cardinals. They went to the Super Bowl last year, lost to New England. Let's see if they can do it again, or will it be another team from the NFC, preferably the Buccaneers? I think we're a playoff team. Maybe not a Super Bowl. Wow, what is up with the Rams and the Patriots? 0-4. Jameis Winston not playing very well. Check his numbers in a sec, but man, a lot of these teams were towards the top last year, not doing very good. And just in case you were wondering, David Cole is leading the NFL in passing yards. Teddy Bridgewater second. Drew Lock is really slinging the rock this year, nearly 300 per game. And then Nick Foles, Carson Wentz, Drew Brees, Andrew Luck. Teddy Bridgewater leads in touchdowns with 15, Kyler Murray 13, Wentz with 12, Cole with 11. So he's doing pretty well this year. Completion percentage. And obviously we can't look at the guys that are only backups, but your highest starter is, I guess, was Wilson hurt? Maybe 831? It's not a great start. 79%, Bridgewater 78, Cole 78. So among the top passers, he's very efficient. And then QBR, another thing that's hard to look at, but if you look at starters, it's Kyler Murray and then David Cole at 133, Bridgewater 132. And here are the numbers for Jameis Winston, 821 through the air this year, 58% passing, 6 touchdowns, 4 interceptions, and surprisingly, only 5 sacks. New England's front line is pretty decent. Unfortunately, Winston, regardless of where he is, just can't cross the hump or climb the hill or whatever the phrase is. That's why we moved on. And I think this is why I love the series so much. This non-usering approach really lets these players' attributes play the big role with their numbers. And I love this. This is really fun. And before we take on the Chiefs, we will make a trade. Justin Evans, it's time for you to go. We're trading with the Browns. It won't be this package. We're going to spice this up a little bit for both sides. Let's make this happen. We'll begin this trade alteration by going to the trade block, and one player I would love to acquire in this trade is second-year linebacker Mack Wilson, who's currently their number 3 linebacker. He's a 67, close to an upgrade. His attributes right now in a pretty good place. I want to make something happen here and get Mack Wilson plus another pick. So the big needs for the Browns are a right tackle, middle linebacker, left tackle, outside linebacker, and strong safety. We are going to obviously trade Justin Evans because they need an upgrade over Tavon Wilson, who's 30 years old. He is a 74. He's an okay athlete. He's got pretty decent coverage ability, much better than Evans. But one thing you can say about Wilson is that he is not very involved in their run defense this season. He only has 14 tackles through the first 4 games. And I assume that run defense is something they want from their strong safety, especially when Wilson doesn't really get involved with tackles behind the line of scrimmage. Only 1 last year, nothing this year. So Wilson, Evans, Kendall Beckwith, and a 2021 fifth round pick in exchange for Mack Wilson and their second round pick this season. And the trade goes through. Evans has good development. Kendall Beckwith is a player they like. This seems like a good trade. And with the trade, MJ Stewart now becomes the starting strong safety. I'm not sure if I want to switch him and Edwards. Doesn't really matter, but Stewart didn't get a ton of playing time last year. He has 8 tackles this year, plus an interception. So that's good news for us because we're going to need someone a little bit stronger in coverage in the box. And that's what Stewart can provide. Can our defense contain Patrick Mahomes this week? That's going to be the big question. The 99 overall quarterback who is only 24 years old. I'm so glad we're not playing him twice a year. Solid accuracies across the board, throwing the run, under pressure, speed. Mahomes is going to be very difficult to contain, and our defense is going to be in for a rough game. But I think maybe we can not get blown out by 30 points. And the stage is set for Cole versus Mahomes Part 1. This could be a major quarterback matchup throughout this series. And I hope to, at some point, run into this team and maybe a Super Bowl. For now, we'll settle for a Week 5 contest, and both teams look to avoid their second loss of the season. Which offense has the edge this week? It'd be hard to tell. Both offenses are really good. This could come down to another last-second, final-drive finish, like what we saw last time against the New York Giants. David Cole leads the team out the tunnel this week, and we'll see what we can do. That's right, Higgins did have that big game last week against Denver. I'm shocked he hasn't gotten a breakout scenario yet. We've had a couple, maybe two or three this series so far. Higgins could really use one. And here we go, everybody. Set to receive are the Buccaneers, and this kick is caught by the wind. Marsh from the 10-yard line to the 28. And we'll see number two, David Cole, take the field. We just saw his numbers. He's been incredible. 11 touchdowns, one interception. He joins Murray for the fewest from starting quarterbacks this year. I should also mention that I did some more tweaking to the playbook for both the offense and the defense. Offensively, we should be in a good place. We will start this game by passing Chris Godwin in motion. Here's a throw to him underneath, and he's up to the 34. Okay, so looks like we're going two passes to begin the game. Cole again will throw. It's quickly O.J. Howard at the 48, already 20 yards. Kansas City's linebackers are not very good. O.J. Howard could be in for another big game. Here's a play fake, Cole. And underneath, Jamison Marsh and Matthew there to wrap him up across midfield. I wonder how often we're going to test this defense deep. We're starting the game with four passes. Maybe I didn't do something right, because it was working last time I checked. Here's a throw. This one is floated. And a little curve on the football there from David Cole. How'd he fit that in there? There was a linebacker right in that window. Just so hard to stop when we're watching the games. First and 10 in a draw this time. Here's Corey Clement spinning away and down to the 30. There's five. And we'll keep the Chiefs defense spread out. It'll be Cole handing off. It's Corey Clement down to the 20. Back-to-back runs. Now 15 yards. That's more than he's had all season. Let's go. Despite Drew Lock playing well, the Denver Broncos are 0-5. They might have the number one pick this year. Here's Cole from the 19. Pass outside, and he had Evans or Godwin. Not really too sure who that was going to, but it'll be second down after the miss. We've had a few of those these past couple of games. Here's a give up the middle. Jordan Howard's first run down to the 14. We are running the ball well this first drive. That's three carries now, but third and four, we go empty. Corey Clement slot left. Here's Cole to the left side and on target for Jamison Marsh. I hate how over-aggressive I need to be with auto subs to get people in and out, but it's the only way to get a good mix of players on the field. Cole with time on first and goal, and he throws to Chris Godwin. Touchdown. That drive was easy peasy lemon squeezy. We are looking good to start. And there he is, everybody. Patrick Mahomes down by 7. What can the defense do to keep him contained? I'm a little nervous right now. All right, defense, keep this lead intact. They start from their own 25-yard line. Kelce to the right, and Tyreek Hill top of the screen. Here's Mahomes, no one open. He'll decide to run and try to outrun Devin White. No, you won't. That ability Mahomes has is really cool, but you're not going to outrun Devin White. He's got 94 speed. And now that I think about it, that is the first sack we've actually seen from our defense while watching the game. We need a lot more of that. They only lost one, so not a big deal now with three tight end look. All three to the right side of the formation, and Mahomes will throw again. This one on target for Travis Kelce. Lavonte David a little too slow there. So one thing we're not going to see a lot from Mahomes is inaccurate passes, all these dead-eye abilities as he throws again in another dead-eye. This one's caught by Hardman, who is now shaken up. I did bump injuries up a little bit to 47, but a first down regardless. They've still got Hill, Kelce, Watkins. I think they'll be fine. First and 10, and an RPO. This one thrown to Hill, who gets up to the 40. Everyone in tight for the Chiefs on second down. They've yet to run the football this game. And Mahomes will hand off, stretch right side. This is Thompson, who can't move the chains. He's met at the first down marker. So third and one. And Mahomes under center once again. Two tight ends. Tyreek Hill top of the screen. They will go play fake. And Mahomes with a throw. This one intended for his tight end. And Mike Edwards, good coverage. No flag. And I don't think they're in field goal range either. What can the offense do this second go around? We already put up seven. We ran the ball pretty well to start. And it will be another give here to Corey Clement, who's getting his fair touch of carries in this game. Like, he's our third down back, so normally when he's in, we're passing. I'm not sure how I want to handle this going forward. Another run, and Clement gets outside. Make a move. Clement gets away from one. Could he go the distance? Matthew gets him at the 44. There we go, run game. It's about time. I like this. I like this a lot. We've got a lot of damage to undo for Clement's stats through the first couple of games. Now it's Howard in a play fake, and Cole will throw underneath O.J. Howard. You can't cover him with a linebacker. What are you going to learn? This is going to be a long game for Kansas City if they keep doing this. Cole making a lot of really good throws. Just had one really bad miss. And a throw outside, and Marsh, what are you doing? Does he have drop pass? I don't think so. That was bad. Here's a third and 10. It'll be Cole passing. This one, two. Who else? O.J. Howard as he fights off a defender. Gets down to the 11. Line him up inside. Line him up outside. You can't cover this kid. A two-touchdown lead here would be fantastic from the 11. Bunch right side and a give to Howard, who can't find space. Second down, Cole underneath. This time Marsh handles it. He's down to the one. That might be a first. Thank you for holding on this time. All right, boys, third and inches. What do we do here? Ace look from the offense. A give to Howard, but a face mask. That'll give us the ball at the half-yard line. And a new set of downs. Hopefully we just keep this on the ground. Okay, we might actually be throwing here. First and goal. Nope, run it again, and this one is going backwards again. We're not blocking well. We've had four plays from the one, and we can't punch this in for some reason. Third and goal, Evans in motion. It might be a drag across the middle. This is Cole to Clement, and he can't just get in the end zone. Come on. Nearly a two-touchdown lead. We'll take three. I do want to sim a little more this week than I have in previous episodes, but I do at least want to give Kansas City another chance to do something, and a good catch there by Tyreek Hill. Good coverage by Murphy Bunting, just not tight enough. We're still going to see a little zone from this defense, not as much as we've seen previously, and they will run it on second down. Nice tackle, Lavonte David. Looks like cover three for us, and a give right up the middle, and I don't think he got there. That might be close. Nope, they didn't get it. David, the first one there, slowed him up, and Sean Murphy Bunting put him down, and the defense forcing another three and out. What a start against this Chiefs offense. What are we doing? It is a punt. Okay, I was a little lost there. This one out of... Oh, my goodness. No, come on. Are you serious? All right, now we got to watch. Because I don't... If I sim, we're probably going to get a safety. Or maybe... I want a sim here. I'll give them a chance. How did that not... You gotta be joking. Gotta be joking. What a punt from Colquitt. I'll give us a chance to get out of trouble through the sim. I do want to see if we run the ball a little more consistently in the simulation, and we are indeed already across the 20. Good mix between Howard and Clement. Back to back to back. Another run for Clement. Third down. And we go backwards. Too many runs. What can the Chiefs do here in the sim? Watkins gets them going with 4. Then Byron Pringle for 12. Darwin Thompson, short run. They give it to him again. Third down. Watkins comes through with 9. That will be a sack for Yannick Ngakoue for the first time this season. It's about time. We're still paying him way too much for 1 sack through 5 games. That needs to improve. Third down and Hargreaves. Come on. That'll give them the ball at the 13. It's a 6-yard run for Thompson from the 7. It's Mahomes to Watkins, and the Chiefs are on the board. Offense back out there for the Buccaneers, and I want to see if we can keep the ball on the ground a little bit more. It's been a fun start. Here's Higgins in motion. They're going to fake the sweep, go to Jordan Howard, who runs right through the defense, and he's got a first down, I believe, gain of 10. 32 yards for him. Clements over 50. It's only the first half, and this is looking like the best running performance we've had all season, regardless of whether or not we're simming. This is why I signed 2 running backs. I don't want all this pressure on Cole. I want the ground game to carry a little of the load, and that's what we're seeing here. And I hope that continues, because this feels good. 15 runs, 15 passes, and here's Cole with pass 16. This one caught, and Higgins thankfully holds on this time. Does Mike Evans have a catch yet? I don't think so. Another give here right down the middle. Howard again, good for 8. And that'll take us to the 2-minute warning. We should be passing more here. We ran back to back, didn't get much. Here's 3rd down and 7. Cole will throw this one to Higgins, and that's not going to move the chains. I guess we will punt. So the Chiefs with a little time left, but they're backed up deep from their own 10. And Mahomes from the gun will look to throw, and here comes Nassib. Pass rush gets through for the 3rd time this game, and they're down at the 3. We could cause some havoc here. I like this. The run game's fixed. Our pass rush is looking better. We're blitzing a little bit more. This is a really good start to week 5. And Kelce was open. Gotta figure they're not going to be throwing here. Mahomes hands off, and Mike Daniels says hello along with Devin White. They lose a yard, and we burn a timeout. So we've got a chance to get the ball back with a little time left in the half. Too tight end look for the Chiefs, and Mahomes under center. Third down, give here, and that is a tackle by Ngakoue. So we stop the clock with 50 seconds. 41 seconds offense, 1 timeout. Can we get points here? Cole to throw. And this pass is contested for Howard. Good coverage by Matthew. Haven't really been testing this defense deep, and I don't think we're going to see that here on 2nd down. Cole will throw underneath. It's Higgins, who has not really stretched the field. And Matthew there again. And unfortunately, we didn't stop the clock, so we're down to 14 seconds with the runoff. Inside 10, Cole throws. It's Howard who's left uncovered again. And we burn a timeout with 7 seconds. So maybe a Hail Mary here? Well, I don't think we're going to be throwing a Hail Mary here. It is Mike Evans in motion. This looks like flanker drive or flanker drag or whatever. And that will end the half. So we don't even try. 10-7 lead. Depending on which way the wind was blowing, I might have actually preferred a field goal there, but we do lead, and it's a pretty decent ball game so far. 96 yards rushing in the first half. What is going on? And it will be Chiefs football to begin this second half. Let's see what they do on offense. As Mahomes is sacked by Lavonte David, that's 4 sacks for the defense. Unfortunately, Travis Kelce is getting going here in the third quarter as they get this inside the red zone already. Then MJ Stewart with the pass interference call, maybe down to the 2-yard line, and it will be a touchdown for Sammy Watkins. So the Chiefs are you know, find a way to get this ball down the field. Our offense needs to find a way to respond. There's Evans, I think, for the first time. David Cole runs for a near first down. Howard does move the chains. Clement for 13 yards, staying busy. Evans for 6. Inside field goal range. There's Higgins. Now Evans again for 9. Second down is Godwin this time. And from the 13 is Tyrann Mathieu with the interception. All right. First turnover of the game goes to the Buccaneers, and we're down by 4. KC with a chance to improve on their lead. Mahomes with a throw outside is Kelce, who moves the chains and picks up 13, maybe 14 yards. Not sure what the coverage was. We've got to get some pressure on Mahomes. From their 46, Mahomes all day throws quickly outside and finds Pringle. Number 13 gets them down to the 26. Hargreaves in coverage wasn't very good. Tight end in motion, maybe a run here. And Mahomes play fake, looking to the flat. There's the tight end who's hit hard. David, good play. Mahomes only has one incompletion so far. We are getting shredded, and these abilities aren't helping. Now a draw. This will get them inside the 30 as he drives down to the 22. Empty look for the Chiefs from the 22. Mahomes needing 6. He's got time. He'll throw to Watkins as he holds on, and that will get them inside the 10. He's already got 2 touchdowns, looking for number 3 this drive. Third quarter winding down, and Kelce isn't on the field here in the red zone. Mahomes going empty as the back goes out to receive. Mahomes will throw to the end zone as Pringle, and they make it a 2-score lead. They're up by 10. Extra point will make it an 11-point game. We need something quick. All right, David Cole, we need that fire, that rookie fire to get us down the field. We'll start with a draw, and the Chiefs were ready for that one this time. Howard's dropped for a 2-yard loss. Cole under center on 2nd and 12 to begin the fourth quarter. And we'll see what we do here on offense here with a 2-score deficit. Cole with a strike down the middle. And O.J. Howard to the 45. Wow, Pittsburgh's up 45-7 over Cincinnati. Here's third down, David Cole. We need something big here. Cole throws, and Chris Godwin is wide open. Big catch. And we're inside field goal range at the minimum. I'm still trying to figure out these auto subs. So O.J. Howard's still getting a bulk of the receptions. But Ricky Seals-Jones at least getting one. Here's a throw outside for Chris Godwin. And another short catch for him. Why are we working under center so much this drive? 3rd down and 3. We need a big catch here from somebody. Cole will throw off the back of Howard. That could have been trouble, but at least we're in range for Matt Gay. 3 points will help here. Okay, so this is where I get a little bit nervous because we're down by 8 points, and this is where the Chiefs could really put this game away. This pass to the running back, and he can't hold on. Nassib there. They're coming out tight again. Tyreek Hill, jet sweep. Nope, play fake. A run. That works too. Good play by Nassib. I need the coverage in the middle of the field to be crisp. They are not going to beat us going down the sideline. Maybe Hill, but not Watkins. Here's Mahomes buying himself time. He will throw this one across the middle. It's nearly picked off by Apple. There we go. Good coverage and a very solid 3-and-out by the defense. From the 36-yard line, we will start. It's David Cole. And this one caught Mike Evans. And he can't get away from LeBlanc. Okay, so what happened again? We're stuck watching the game, which I don't necessarily mind. We're down by 8. 6 minutes left. And here's a give to Jordan Howard running right through the defense. Another huge run. I knew this line could block for the run. I knew it. And we're doing it pretty well this week. I almost want to put together, like, different game plans for different defenses we're going to be facing. And a catch there by Howard again. Cole now 39 pass attempts. So we're still running the ball well. Cole's still getting his passes. And O.J. Howard again over 100 yards. And another throw. Higgins can't hold on. 4:48 to go. Split back look for the Buccaneers. And here comes pressure. Cole to Clement, who's all alone. Can Clement go the distance? No, he's too slow. 87 speed, but a great play for him again. This is where we can't lollygag. We need a score quick. 441, and Cole will hand off Clement down the middle to the 10. We'll go five wide, only one linebacker in the middle of the field. Now will be a great time for a QB draw. Cole will throw, though, to the end zone, and Marsh has it, touchdown! His first score of the season, and we still need a two-point conversion, or maybe we take the extra point and let the defense kind of do their job. I really hope he got that right foot down. I can't really tell. It looks like he did. He did. That catch is good. We have the touchdown. And now the question is, what do we want to do here for the two-point try? This part of the playbook is a bit weird. It will be a handoff left side. Mike Evans with the block, and that's going for two. We tie the game with 4:09 left. Plenty of time, but we are looking good. I can't believe I fixed the playbook. We're running well, we're passing well, and everything's going smooth, but we need the defense to make a stand. This right now is still anyone's game. Mahomes has only missed three completions so far. Three touchdowns, two to Watkins, one to Pringle. And now would be a great time for this secondary to wake up. 4:05 to go. We're actually killing them in yardage. We're just not getting the points we need, which was the issue in week one. All right, they lose two. Then they come out stacked. Tyreek Hill, Kelsey top of the screen. And a throw to the outside. That's Watkins again. Another stop here on third down would be great defense. They need 6 yards. 3:34 to go at their own 32-yard line. Mahomes will throw this one outside. It's well covered. Eli Apple there again. Pringle can't move the chains. Defense does their job. That's what they're paid to do. Let's go. 285, two scores, and an interception. This game is certainly living up to the hype. Can David Cole deliver? We start from the 20 under 3 minutes on the clock. And we will start from the shotgun. David Cole will throw all day. He's got a man that is O.J. Howard, who comes through again. He is so much fun to watch. Just keep giving him the ball. Clock down to 2:27. We're taking our sweet time here to hand off to Howard, who cuts outside for some reason, and we lose a yard. Clock down to the final 2 minutes. Now will be a great time to get a big play down the field. It'll be Cole under center, and he will throw again. Pressure in his face, and he had Evans, but can't hit him in stride. That's incomplete. Now 3rd and 10. And we're under center again. I mean, I guess, but our shotgun formations are where the better pass plays are. Here's Cole, 3rd down, flag down, and this time Cole finds Evans, but that is probably going to be holding, and a bad time for a penalty, as that will indeed back us up. Thank you, Ollie Marpet. And then we come out in a look that's definitely not going to pick up 20 yards. All right, so that's frustrating. If we lose this game, blame that play. That made absolutely no sense, and this will be not fair caught. Come on, smack Hill. Knock the ball loose. Why did he get away from you guys? Come on. Make plays. So what do the Chiefs do with 1:38 to go? Two timeouts on the board. We are in a really weird look on defense, and that's not helping things, as that throw goes to Hill, and he doesn't get far. Another 12-second runoff. They're really taking their time here. Mahomes will throw underneath, and Watkins will move the chains, get across midfield, and they will not burn a timeout again. Inside the final minute defense, we need some big plays here. Mahomes with time. Vea nearly got fair off in time, though, and Pringle gets around 5. So they need to get to the 35-yard line. 29 seconds, Mahomes. We'll throw underneath. This is caught. That will move the chains again. Timeout. Clock down to 23 seconds, and we are stacking the line. Looks like we're bringing pressure, and that will be a false start. Hopefully it will. Appreciate that. From the 44, Mahomes will throw again. Time looking left. This is caught. Pringle. No, he dropped it. MJ Stewart nearly off the tip. Half the interception. That could have been huge. 19 seconds. Again, not sure which way the wind is blowing, so it's hard to tell if they actually need the 35-yard line or not, but it won't matter, and a face mask on top of it. That is likely going to do it here. We almost had it. Almost. I'm expecting a quick run to take time off the clock. They will indeed hand it off. Levante David Thayer. And they are down to... Oh, alright, EA. So, they're not aware they had a timeout to burn. This game frustrates me. We should have lost this game. We should have lost. Now we're going to overtime. Kansas City with the football first. We'll see if they can end things in overtime. They start from their own 27. Here's Mahomes with good protection. And Tyreek Hill to the 39. I'll be honest here. I really don't want to win this game. We should have lost. And I'm going to kind of root for the Chiefs here to get this ball down the field. But not too heavily. What a catch from Travis Kelce. They need a touchdown to win, though. That 35-yard line doesn't really mean much. Here's Mahomes outside. This is Kelce again. Not much there. They do need the 35 for first down. Mahomes play fake. Pass rush not getting there. This pass to the sideline and picked off is MJ Stewart. I'm not sure how I feel about that pick, but we take over at the 33 with plenty of time to get back down the field. So Cole gets intercepted. And Mahomes now picked off once, but Mahomes has three touchdowns. So Cole could technically match his effort with a big score here. And that interception, of course, won't stand. I'm just going to hope the play calling isn't weird here as David Cole takes the field nearly 300 yards again. That's got to be some kind of record for a rookie as we start from the 33. Cole will hand off. Here's Howard getting away from one and tracked down by Matthew from behind. One player's name we have not called yet that's both watching and in the sim has been Chris Jones for the Chiefs, and a big throw and catch there. OJ Howard gets us across midfield. Now 139, Pro Bowl, he's going. I'm going to assume we have the win because our distance to reach field goal range is much longer than the Chiefs were on the other side as Howard picks up 9. So what do we do here from the 38? Likely keeping it on the ground. Corey Clement in the backfield. It will be a give to Clement, who is met, but he moved the chains. From the 37, I wouldn't be upset with getting a little bit closer. We're going with the sweep. What a time to call that play. We will see that on occasion. It's more of a thing for our goal line package, but not a bad decision. Just wasn't the best situation to call that in. We lose 5 yards from the 42. Cole underneath. This is caught. That is Chris Godwin to the 32-yard line. So 3rd and 5. We're in field goal range. Clock still running. We still have 2 timeouts. Cole will take the check down. Jordan Howard inside the 20. Down to the 15. And we should maybe call a timeout or just kick 3 points here. Okay, so we're going to keep the offense on the field. Then a play fake for David Cole. He will look to pass, and this throw is thrown away. Not sure what we're doing here. Just kick 3 points. I trust Matt Gay. We're going screen. This is not a smart selection of plays late. What are we doing? 3rd down, 17 yards to go. We're going with Corey Clement down to the 12, and we don't call a timeout. 29-yard attempt from the left hash. Kansas City called a timeout to try to ice Matt Gay, but the kick is up, and the kick is good. And the Buccaneers take week 5. Again, I'm not sure how I feel about this victory, but a win is a win. And technically, we got cheated by the clock runoff back in week 3, so this is a little revenge against the game. Although, at the end of the day, this is the kind of stuff that needs to get fixed. This clock management issue by the CPU started, what, like 2-3 years ago, and it's still an issue. Maybe they can patch it, but it needs to get fixed. But one thing that did get fixed this week, our offense. 128 on the ground, our best mark this season. We find a way to get our ground game involved this week, but also find a way to keep David Cole very involved in the pass game. 334 for the rookie, 3rd downs, we were great. Could have done without some of the penalties, especially that holding call late in the game, but overall good game. David Cole with his lowest QBR of the season, 98.5, 37 of 49 passing for 334. two touchdowns, one interception, and longest pass went 22 yards. On the ground this week, Jordan Howard 16 for 63, Corey Clement 10 for 68. This is exactly where I want this ground game to be. Like, 20-25 carries a game between our two top backs, that's the sweet spot. I really wish OJ Howard could play half this well when we sim, but for whatever reason, he just doesn't get the receptions and the yards when we're simulating. Godwin had a touchdown, Evans only 33 yards, Corey Clement stayed involved, Jamison Marsh first score of the season, great game. Devin White and Lavonte David putting up big numbers against KC, 12 tackles for White, 10 for Lavonte David, both with a sack. Vernon Hargreaves, 9 tackles, Sean Murphy bunting 7, Eli Apple with 6 and 1 for a loss. And Ngakoue, 4 tackles and his first sack of the season, 1 of 4, including Devin White, Lavonte David, and of course, Nassib, good game. And of course, in his first start, MJ Stewart with the interception. Big play that helped us win this game. I appreciate the hard work. Ryan Jensen had a good game keeping David Cole upright for the entirety of this ball game, and we're going to stick with the pass protector upgrades for him. Got to find a way to keep our QB on his feet, and we only get one upgrade for finesse. Not sure how much playing time Mac Wilson got this game outside of special teams, maybe a few tackles in the sim, but we're just going to stick with field general for him. I think we'll start working on some other specialty stuff next season during the preseason, but that is not a bad upgrade there. A little tackle, a little block shedding, a little play wreck. Back-to-back games for Tampa Bay going to overtime and another win, this time against in-division rivals. The Atlanta Falcons fall 34-28. Another good game for the run game. Our pass game looked pretty good. Another turnover, but it is looking pretty good right now for this offense. 5 red zone touchdowns and time of possession. That's what I want to see. Cole can't hit the 300-yard mark this ball game, but 279 plus 3 touchdowns and another interception that puts him at 3 on the year. Sacked once, throwing 66%, and Matt Ryan on the other side threw 65%, sacked twice, and he had 2 touchdowns. We ran the ball even more this game. 24 carries for Howard for 80 yards, and Corey Clement had 12 for 37. Both found the end zone. Production is picking up big time, and David Cole, 8 yards and a broken tackle. Get off my quarterback. Big game for Mike Evans after not doing a lot back in week 5. 10 receptions, 133, and 2 scores. Evans is 100% on pace right now for 1,000 yards. So is Chris Godwin. Hopefully we keep this production up. OJ Howard, though, big fall off. 2 grabs, only 15 yards. Lavonte David this week with 13 tackles. Devin White only had 5. MJ Stewart with 7. These tackles a lot more spread out this week. Jordan Whitehead had 3. Only 3 tackles for a loss. 1 from David, 1 from Vea, 1 from Ngakoue. And the sacks this game both went to Mike Daniels. So big stat line for him. And the interception goes to Mike Edwards. Good game. So we haven't looked at draft stories since earlier in the season. A few to catch up on here. Barry Geathers apparently can't be guarded. Dennis Dansby has some attitude issues. Injury concerns for Khalil Hemingway, who's one of the safeties I like, I'm pretty sure. And Tyler Beckham, who is the top corner on the draft board this year, he matched up against Dominic Riley, and apparently Riley had him looking silly. That's interesting. Okay, so I wasn't expecting this. Both Barry Geathers and Dominic Riley are tight ends. Both are third round graded. Geathers 23 and B catching traffic, C plus catching, and C plus short, a mid second round talent player in the mid third round. That is not shabby. He's 23, 6'3, 255. What about Dominic Riley, who is 6'3, 272? Top threes are great, but obviously combines will be the determining factor. Riley is 21, so a little more upside. C plus catch and traffic, C plus spec, and C plus short route running. Another solid top three. Another upgrade here for David Cole, who's a 79 overall, could move to an 80 with this upgrade. He is close to unlocking his development trait, so we will know it after the game against New Orleans, which we will send before we end this episode. We went with Scrambler last time. We're going to go Strong Arm this time. Get a little deep accuracy. Hopefully, we get two upgrades, and one is for deep, and one is for medium. So he's a 79 overall, 81 deep, 88 medium, 87 short. He is lethal. Feliciano's also getting an upgrade this week, our 77 overall right tackle. He's got an ability. He's got superstar dev. Let's go. That is huge. And do we have an ability? Nope, we gotta wait till 80. So Feliciano, already a fairly good pass protector. And I think that the ability you get is based off the archetype. So I think we're gonna go with pass protector. Get something to help him against those insta sheds, and we get a little to finesse and power plus two awareness. Upgrade here as well for third string tight end Jordan Leggett, who is looking for a new contract this year. Between him and Ricky Seals-Jones, I think I'd rather go Leggett, especially if one of these tight ends in the draft ends up being decent. We get plus a lot there. That's not bad. Justin Watson, first upgrade of the season. I don't think he's seen the field at all when we're watching games. And yeah, he has no catches this year. I mean, I'm trying to get auto subs to mix in a few of our backups. But when you're so far down on the depth chart, Evans, Godwin, Higgins, Marsh, I think Miller is ahead of Watson right now. Maybe not. We'll go deep threat. 71 overall now. A lot of upgrades, which should hopefully maybe get him on the field, but I don't think so. That's now three games in a row that have gone to overtime for the Buccaneers, but this time we will fall. Saints win 23-17. Run game not great this week. No turnovers. 294 passing, so another sub-300-yard passing game for David Cole. And it looks like we were 2-for-4 in the red zone. What happened? Did we miss a field goal or something, or did we just not score? 279 for David Cole this week, and another two touchdowns, no interceptions. That is big news. Sacked twice, and he throws 24-37, so 64% for him and Drew Brees this week. And Brees had 221 and only one touchdown. He was also sacked twice. Okay, so can someone explain to me why I spent so much money improving our defensive line and we give up 152 and 10 yards a carry to Alvin Kamara and a touchdown? What happened? And not a great game for our receiving core. Corey Clement, 6 receptions, 78 yards, led the team in a touchdown. Higgins had 59, Howard 53, Chris Godwin, Mike Evans, bit of a drop off, only 2-for-40. Not a big fan of how this stat line looked this week. And our top three players in tackles are secondary players. That's always a bad sign. Mike Daniels did get involved. Vita Vea, 7 tackles. We only had 5 for a loss, 3 from Nassib, 1 from Daniels, 1 from Vea. Sacks this game, 1 for Ngakoue, half a sack for Vea, and half for Hargreaves. So not bad, but also not great. So a 5-2 record before the bye. We obviously have watched 3 games, and I think we're on pace to watch 6. And we've got some big games in the second half of the year. Saints, Bears, Panthers, Packers, Raiders, Chargers, Falcons, Lions, and the Vikings. And with that loss, the division lead is now tied, but it's a very tight race overall here with still half a season left to go. I don't think we're making any big moves to move someone at the deadline. I do like who we have currently, and I am okay with David Cole having superstar development as well. Let's go! 79 overall, and we actually... Okay, so you do get abilities before 80 for quarterbacks. Lofting Deadeye is perfect for those down-the-field passes. We hopefully get to Mike Evans at some point, and Anchored Extender. Good for those blitzing DBs we occasionally see. Although I have been trying to work on his break sack rating just across the board, which is why we went Scrambler last time. But David Cole, in his rookie season, halfway through, 18 touchdowns, 3 interceptions. Rookie of the year is a lock, maybe a Pro Bowl. So what a way to end the episode. 2 rookies have superstar dev. We're still waiting for Marsh, and we're still waiting for Archer Young, which might not happen this year. I think we'll kick off next episode by simming week 9, then playing the Bears, and then wrapping up against the Panthers. And then I think next episode after that, I want to watch the game against the Chargers. I kind of want to watch Green Bay in Week 12. I really want to watch a road game, and both of them are road games. So I guess we'll see which matchup is better when we get to that point. But thank you all for tuning in to this episode of the Tampa Bay Buccaneers franchise. Season 2 just got a lot better. Catch you guys next time.